Hey guys, welcome back. Andrew here with Little Box Effects, and welcome to Little Box. Well, kind of. Little Box is an all online, highly curated retail shop I started a few years back, and I run it out of my home. It's just me handpicking some of my favorite pedals and pieces of gear from around the world. And I thought that I'd do a little update as we head into a new month here and just kind of give you a rundown of some of the new pedals and products you can see in the shop, some things that have just been released or things that I'm excited about having and offering to you at Little Box. Thank you guys as always for your support, for your business. Thanks for following along on this channel here. Really appreciate it. If you're new to the channel, hit subscribe below. If you want to drop a comment with a brand or a product that you've been itching to try or see at Little Box, do that below, and I'd love to be exposed to new pieces of gear that you're thinking about, or perhaps circle up with new dealers to see if we can add them to the lineup here at Little Box. I have a stack of pedals. A lot of them are new to the shop here, perhaps new releases, things that I've gotten in recently, and I'm just going to pick one up and talk about it, introduce it to you, and move along. The first one is this mustard yellow Montreal Assembly Count to Five. One of my favorite offerings at Little Box, and we're doing another run of these pedals. So the Count to Five is got a cult following, just kind of a singular type micro looper, reverse delay, shimmery, kind of textural, cool pedal. And it has just been a favorite of experimental, ambient, soundscapey, players for years, and I'm super excited to be able to offer this in a Little Box exclusive mustard yellow with some cool custom knobs. We're doing another batch of these, and they should be ready in the next 6 to 8 weeks, depending on production times. You can hit the link, head over to Little Box and pre-order one now. I'm also excited to announce that I'm teaming up with a good friend of mine, John, from the channel Signal Path. He is celebrating the second year of his channel, and we're celebrating by giving away one of these pedals. So head over to his channel, give it a follow, and hit the link below for the giveaway to enter. Moving along, we have a whole lineup of pedals from Tubesteader. This is a small builder out of Canada. This model is the Lightkeeper. It's a Dumble style preamp and overdrive pedal, and these pedals are tube driven. They operate with a real tube up at, you know, 300-ish volts internally there, so you're getting some really cool tube warmth, saturation, texture, dynamics from these pedals. He's doing really cool work. I demoed this over my Ambient Endeavors channel and was really pretty blown away by the sounds, and you could hear it in the intro sketch too. I'm using this into a UA aux stomp, and you can use these pedals essentially like an amp on board your pedal board. If you've got a favorite IR loader or cab simulator, they work really well going into those types of things. So we have the Lightkeeper. We have the Magnesium. This is a dual channel preamp that's patterned after a vintage Magnetone amp. And there's a few other offerings available in the shop now. So check out them. Tubesteader up in Canada doing some really cool tube driven preamp pedals. The next pedal you heard in the intro sketch as well, this is the Fjord Fuzz Mime. It's been a few months since it was released. It's an AI generated reverb pedal with two modes and a really cool feedback control on the left foot switch. Really fun for ambient post-rock shoegaze sounds, and just kind of a cool concept. Daniel fed some prompts into chatbot and got out a schematic that he tweaked a bit and released as this pedal. So this is the Mime. It's available in our exclusive colorway, the whiteout version. We've also got Soul, which is the recent release of Fuzz and Univibe combined. Some really cool sounds in those pedals. And we've got a whole lineup of Fjord Fuzz in the shop right now, so check those out. Moving on, this is the Analog Music Company, So High, So Low. And there's kind of a story and an update on this specific pedal. So this colorway was also exclusive to the shop. We sold out of the original batch of these, and they should all be to their customers by now. We have another batch of the remaining inventory coming in. This builder's over in the Ukraine, which, as you can imagine, is having quite a tumultuous and uncertain set of days and events over there. So I get updates from him pretty often. He's been incredibly communicative and great to work with in that regard. And for those of you waiting on your So High, So Lows, they're coming. They should be shipping out from the Ukraine in the coming days. There's been, like I mentioned, some delays and some hiccups there on that front for a number of different reasons, but they should be coming soon. And we'll be getting those out to end customers as soon as we possibly can here. So So High, So Low, a really cool filter and saturator patterned after some old synth style filter circuits. And there's still a few colorways and a few units available to pre-order here from the upcoming batch. We just got these EAE Model FET in the custom Dragon's Blood Red aesthetic here. We got a very small batch of these in. The Model FETs are really cool, again, preamp style pedal that is patterned after the Sun Model T with John Snyder's take and refinement to it in pedal form. Again, this pedal works really, really well in those direct rigs if you've got an IR loader to feed this into as your amp. It also works great as a really powerful clean boost or just like an amp-like saturate and texture thing as an overdriver distortion when cranked. So check out the Model FET. These are limited in this colorway and they won't be around for too long. Moving on, we are restocked with the Benson Delay, one of my favorite delays that came out last year. A really cool PT2399 with awesome modulation, tap tempo with subdivisions, that sort of thing. And it just sounds really great. A nice, warm, kind of analog-y tape sounding delay. They're back in stock here and you can pick one up at Little Box now. While we're on the subject, we have a fresh batch of the Benson Germanium Boosts here. My buddy Mark Johnston demoed this pedal in some cool studio contexts recently on the channel, so you can check that video out. And it's one of my favorite, if not my favorite, boost pedals. It's dead simple. It adds a touch of compression and just some sparkle and vibrancy to your tone. I like to use it at the very front of my board and kind of set my always-on clean tone with it and then feed into my drives and wet effects. Just a really awesome tool to use on your pedal board or for your bass or in your studio for different sort of studio boosting magic. We have already sold through our initial batch of the Benson Germanium preamps. Those have been a hit. I've really enjoyed playing that in my own setup, and we're expecting some more units in. And so if you want to grab one of those, connect with us at the shop and we can hold one for you from the new batch. Moving on, a relatively new offering from Bondi FX. This is the Squishaz compressor. I use it on my main board every week and I used it in the intro sketch as you heard. It's just one of the very best front of chain always on compressors that I've ever played. It has a really nice range of compression from pretty subtle and mild to pretty squishy, as the name would imply. And you can also use the tilt style EQ and the onboard volume control to use it as sort of a boost and compressor, which I sometimes do. Just a really, really awesome, really well refined compressor from Bondi, the Squishaz. We still have a few of these in stock along with some of the other offerings from Bondi. Last but not least, we have this, the Replay from Von Gaun. This was released last week, I believe. A really cool, compact, really approachable synth with some fun features, a cool arpeggiator, just a really, really fun tool. I've been enjoying using it in the studio here. And as a guitar player who kind of lives mainly in the guitar world with pedal boards of effects and things like that, this Replay has been really fun to integrate into my setup, even using it on a pedal board with some outboard effects and things like that to add synth layers and textures to pieces as I'm writing them without having to really learn a huge workflow or interface from some of the other desktop synths that are out there. So Replay is a really cool option for some of those folks that want kind of a really pretty approachable entry point for synth, or want to use it in conjunction with some of their existing pedal board workflows and things like that. We have some of these in stock and shipping right now. So that's just a brief overview of some of the recent releases that we've added to the lineup, some fun projects that we have going on. I want to circle back and remind you the count to five we're giving away with Signal Path. Check out the giveaway link below there, and good luck to those that are entering. You can also pick up that pedal on pre-order right now. Those are limited to about 30 units from this batch, so don't wait around to get in on that. Hit the little box link below and grab one of those today. Oh, I have one more thing. You might have seen I was playing the Balaguer Ambient Select Espada in the intro sketch. Still a fantastic guitar that's got a ton of versatility in that offset style with some cool features and appointments. We are all sold through of the initial batch of those that I had in last year, but if you are curious or interested in picking up one of these guitars, if you missed out on the first batch, please shoot me an email. That's all I'm gonna say. We have some really fun stuff cooking with the next batch of Ambient Select Espadas that I can't really get into yet, but if you wanna drop me a note, I can give you the details, I can talk through some of the timelines and perhaps get one pre-ordered for you here. So hit me up directly via email about that if you're interested in the Ambient Select Espadas from Balaguer. Otherwise, we'll talk soon. Thanks for checking this video out. Again, thanks so much for the support. Drop me an email or a question on Instagram with anything you've got or are curious about. I'd love to talk to you. I'd love to help you figure out what you're looking for and how you can kind of maximize your rig and find your tone. Have a good week, and we'll talk to you soon.